Hello guys, good afternoon from Brazil. It's me, your soup friend, the soup guy, Silvio Jr. Soup guy, yes, that's my nickname. So guys, it's such a pleasure to speak with you, especially, you know, everyone who's been following my soap channel and everything else that I do about soaps. And I'm going to talk a little bit about myself. I am Brazilian. I am an English and Portuguese teacher. I am passionate about literature, English and Portuguese, and of course, the Spanish one. I am passionate about languages, that's the point. And, you know, ever since I started college, I decided to talk about soap operas or telenovelas, as we say here in Brazil and, of course, the other Latin countries. And I'm going to explain why. But to explain, I just need a sad song, okay? Because it's not easy for me to say that. Now, guys, you're gonna know the truth. So, guys, it all started like this. I was learning English. I was a teenager back then. And I remember that one of the students was talking to the teacher, our teacher back then, and he asked her, how could I say a novella in English, teacher? And she said, soap opera. And I was interested about it, but nobody said anything, and neither did I. But years later, you know, when I went to college to become a teacher, one of my teachers, one of my literature teachers, Portuguese literature teacher, she was kind of mean to me, you know. It's ridiculous, but she was. I asked her the following question. What did the word romance mean, you know? Because she was holding a book, she was holding a novel, it was Twilight, you know, and back then I didn't know that novels could also represent something a little bit dark, you know, I mean, like, you know, stories with blood and violence. I didn't know that, you know. I was still learning literature. I was getting into that area, you know, which I love nowadays. And she got furious at me because I asked her this question, and she said, because a novel is a novel, and that's it. And I said, but why do you call a novel? I mean, there is violence and there is blood and something else, you know, about this book that you're holding. And she said, it is a novel, and that's it. And then I asked for the third time, and she didn't like it. She almost screamed. She said, because it is a novel. In Portuguese, we don't say novel, we say romance, but it's the same, right? And I was like, okay, shut up, don't say anything. And when I came home, I started searching for it on Wikipedia, Google, Facebook, and I was really, oh my gosh, how can I say? I was really impressed, because I realized that the United States, the UK, and other countries also produced soap operas, you know, or telenovelas for that matter. And I was like, oh, they also produced that, because back then, I thought that, you know, the other countries only produced movies and TV series. Of course, everything's a series, but I'm talking about just, you know, a TV show that's broadcasted once a week, like I have here on my shelf. I have The OC, Friends, Sex and the City, and other TV shows. I love them, of course. And I was like, oh my gosh, they also have soaps. They have TV shows that are broadcasted, you know, Monday through Friday. And I was astonished when I found out that Guiding Light was on air for 72 years, because, you know, that's a lifetime, guys, you know. I was like, oh my god, I can't believe they have that kind of show. Because the only difference between a soap opera and a telenovela is the time, you know, because the cliche, the whole drama, the violence, a little bit of violence, the love, and love and everything else, the romance is there, you know. But when it comes to us, the Latin people here in America, or maybe in Europe, in Portugal, Telenovelas are like they have almost 200 episodes, you know, and that's it. But when it comes to soaps, it's longer, you know. My gosh, I mean, Days of Our Lives, The Young, the Restless, The Bold and the Beautiful, and General Hospital, those shows that I truly worship, they are still, you know, on the air. But I have to confess that All My Children was my very first American soap opera, and that's how I got to meet the incredible Susan Lucci. I love her, she's an amazing actress, and she's great. And I love her scenes with the actor, you know, Vincent Irizarry, you know, because they were like the soap villains sometimes, and it was pretty cool to watch them. But of course, I am also a huge fan of the British soaps, like Emmerdale, EastEnders, Coronation Street. My gosh, Coronation Street is, you know, forever, you know. And that's why I decided to create my channel and talk about it on Facebook as well. So I would like to share with you the link. It's right over there. It's right here, right? It's here, and you guys can check it out. Please follow me. Take a look at my work. I hope you appreciate it. And, you know, it's all about the storytelling. Storytelling is amazing, and it will never end because, like I always say, and I say that to my students, don't judge the actor all the time, but judge the writer, because he's the one who's trying to tell us something, and that something may be very important to all of us, and it doesn't matter because he may be criticizing or not. Maybe he's just being ironic. And that's it, and thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you guys keep up with me, and kisses and hugs to all. See you guys. See you.